Hi there, thank you very much for tuning in again, and I've got another unboxing for you. It's a LiPo balance charger from Hobby King, the reactor, 300 watt, 20 amps, and I'll take it out of its box right away. Okay, bunch of wires. And a manual. Okay, that was the box. Okay, the wrapping. All right. Now, first thing I noticed is that it's quite small, smaller than I had expected. And that's mainly because it's well, this is the charger it will be replacing. Let me see if that's in screen. No, it isn't. There you go. As you can see, the old charger is substantially bigger, and while it is less powerful. That's progress, I guess. This is a 150 watt balance charger. This is a 300 watt, twice as powerful, but still substantially smaller. Now, the reason that I'm replacing this charger is because it has a screen error. Sometimes the backlight fails, sometimes it displays garbage. It still runs, it works, but well, so I'll just leave that as a backup charger. Now, one big change here is that this charger, the smallest balance port is 3S. So without another breakout port, you can't balance charge 2S LiPos with this one. That was always inconvenient, but as you can see, this charger, the smallest balance port is 2S, so very nice, thank you very much. Okay, let's see what else comes in the box. The power cables are already connected to the charger. You can't take them off. And as you can see, it has banana plugs, much better than the clamp style ones that the old charger came with. And it came with two big, very big alligator clips that you can put on these bullet connectors, like so. But this one I'll be using in-house, so I won't be using these alligator clips. Alright, it also comes with these charge cables for your LiPo with alligator clips. I won't be using those either, but if you have if you want to charge some kind of LiPo for which you don't have a proper connector, you might be able to use those. And it comes with a charge lead without a connector, so you can solder up the connector you'd want to use with it. And it comes with this. I'm not sure. I suspect it's a temperature sensor, which is nice. Okay, apart from that, the charger has a few input ports, a port for a temp sensor over here, and a mini USB port. I'm not sure what you can use that for. The old charger also had a USB port. I've never used that. Okay, and the last thing that comes with the charger is a manual. Well, if you're familiar with these kinds of chargers, you won't be needing the manual much. Well, as it is now, it's only a paperweight, of course. So I'll hook it up and I'll take the camera to my charging station and show you what it looks like when it's switched on. Hold on. Okay, here is an overall look of my charging station. It's a bit of a mess at the moment because I'm sorting out things, but here are two dime a dozen copy of a copy of a copy chargers with internal power supplies, so I can use those anywhere. And here is another Turnigy AcuCell. I had two of those. And here's the new charger. And alright, let's switch everything on. Power supply for everything. And this is a distribution port. There, and with that everything is switched on. Now, let me give you a more close-up look of the new charger, just a second. Okay, I hope you can read the screen well enough. Now, once again, this is just another charger, I think, with four buttons and a screen. But let me take you through the menus regardless of that. Lithium battery, NIM, okay, NIC, lead battery, settings, special modes, I'm new to that. Okay, enter, motor drive, foam cutter, you can use this charger as a power supply for a foam cutter. Interesting. Measure internal resistance. Okay, that was that. Okay, and save settings, load settings, log files. Okay, maybe you can read those log files via the USB connector. I'm not sure, but that would be nice. And we're back to lithium. Okay, let's enter that section. And what's nice here, I think, is that it charges, it starts in balance mode. Most chargers I've had so far start in LiPo charge mode. And I almost always use the balance charge mode. So why not start there, right? So thank you very much. And second, normal charge, okay, fast charge, okay, storage, nothing new, discharge, discharge plus, I'm not sure what the difference is, and cycle mode, that's nice, that's new to me, and a LiPo monitor, that is also new to me. And we're back to balance charge. And you might have noticed that it says auto here for your LiPo mode, which is nice. So I should be able to balance charge a LiPo without telling the charger what kind of LiPo it is. So let's connect a LiPo. There, it's connected to the balance port. And you won't be able to see this, but I'm also connecting a Deans plug here. Okay, balance charge, 2 amps, yeah, that's okay. Start. Battery check, please wait. Okay, well, as you can see, it has figured out that it's a 3-cell LiPo, and it is. And it's charging at 2 amps. Let's see. Here are the cells. Okay. Okay. End voltage, you can set the end voltage. Capacity cutoff. Safety timer. Temperature cutoff. I don't have a temperature sensor connected now, but you can. Alright, in short, this charger has a lot more functions than my previous charger. And it's smaller. Yeah. Nice. One other thing of note is that the fan isn't turning at the moment. Which is perfectly fine. It's not hot, of course. I just set it up. My previous charger always had the fan blowing, so very nice. How do I get back to the... this is the normal charging screen here. Okay. Well, that's it for the charger. If you have any questions about it, please let me know and I'll try to answer them. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.